हेलो हेलो, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल सर. गुड आफ्टरनून सर. गुड
गुड आफ्टरनून.
आफ्टरनून सर, यू आर ऑडिबल सर.
माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल?
यस सर, यस सर, यस सर. इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स एंड रोबोटिक्स इज विजिबल
या
सर.
यस सर, वेलकम यू सर. इट्स ऑडिबल एंड विजिबल. लेट अस स्टार्ट फॉर्मली द सेशन. वेलकम सर.
थैंक यू.
यस सर. Good afternoon, all of you. Welcome you all for the day 4 afternoon session. I'm glad to introduce afternoon session resource person, Mr. Rajshekhar V.S., Project Assistant, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Mr. Rajshekhar is currently a project assistant at the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. He has finished his Master's in Advanced Manufacturing Technology from Sastra University, Tanjore, Tamil Nadu, India. His area of interest is bio-inspired robotics and mechanism design for robotics. He has published 22 papers in the area of robotics and holds a US patent as well for his invention titled Robotic Snake. I welcome you, sir. Welcome you all to the afternoon session. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thanks for the kind introduction. Can I proceed with the talk?
Yes, sir. 2 o'clock onwards, we can start the session, sir. But however, participants are very lesser in number. We will communicate with them through WhatsApp as well, sir. Maybe slowly in 2 to 3 minutes after it reaches 50. Every time, minimum 80 participants were there. We will motivate them through WhatsApp to come and join. Maybe we can start in 1 or 2 minutes, sir.
Yeah, sure. You just let me know when I
can. Sure, sir. Sure, sir. If the participant count goes more than 40 plus, no, sir, immediately we can start. That's all, sir. That is the only indication we are also using.
Okay.
Post-lunch only this happens. Morning, they are a bit earlier and joining. Post-lunch, this issue.
Okay.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there is a question. Is there any prerequisite record for your session? They were asking, sir, because already you started the communication thread with the participants. So they are asking the question, is there any prerequisite to attend your session or what supposed to be done?
We just need a laptop and a processing software, as I had mentioned in the group. So if you haven't downloaded the processing software, you can download it. I'll be sending the link shortly, the chat box.
Yeah, a resource person has shared the link for the demonstration session to do with our laptop. good that one person already installed and downloaded, Dr. Marudupandi. That's glad to hear.
Okay, there is another link which I am sending. This is the files which we will be utilizing for the today's afternoon session and tomorrow's morning session. If you haven't downloaded it, please download it.
It's glad to see that many member already installed and downloaded, Arna ma'am and Ramachandra sir. If not, let us take 1 or 2 minutes to download it, then slowly we can get into the session. Yeah, fine. Thank you, Ramya madam. Good that Suresh sir also have done.
Can we start the session?
Yes, sir. Normally with the 40 to 50 we used to start, sir. Then slowly they will join, sir.
Okay. A very good afternoon to everyone. My name is V.S. Rajashekar and today I'm going to talk about Internet of Things in Robotics. This is the first session which I'm handling and it will be on computer controlled robots. I'm a project assistant at Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. My areas of interest lies in the following. That is mobile robots, bio-inspired robots, computer-aided multi-body dynamics, manipulators, aerial grasping, computer-controlled robots, mechanism design, and complaint robots. Whatever robot I make, I usually try to connect it with the computer so that it can be accessible and I can show it to my friends who are not with me in India. So today, I'll be also showing a RoboNow, which you can see. And with this, we'll start with the session. So the topics which are going to cover is introduction to computer controlled robots, three-axis robotic arm. This is a virtual arm. And next is a song controlled virtual robotic arm, augmented reality, that is controlling our robotic arm, and computer vision, tracking a ball's trajectory. So I'll now share my video so that you can see what the robo I'm going to control. I hope you are able to see the program on the screen. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm running this program so that you can see a robo, a hardware of the robo. I hope you are able to see the screen. The robo is just shaking his hands. So if I move the slider over here, the robot's head will move. If I move the hand, left hand, the left hand of the robot will move. This is actually a mirror image of the video. So I like to give some remote control to some participants so that they can try and see this robo. So anyone who is interested can tell their name. Hello, ma'am. Can you hear me, participants?
Yes, sir.
If you like to control the robo and see from your own desktop, this robo, you can control and see right now. So can you please tell your name? I can give access.
Myself, Ramchandra Rao here, sir.
So your name is Ramchandra Rao? Or?
Yeah.
So I hope you are able to move the cursor.
Oh, sir. Yeah. My mouse cursor. No, sir. It's okay, sir.
So, Mr. Marudu Pandi, if you are online, I can try giving access to you. Please try to move your mouse.
Tell me, sir.
Yeah, can you try moving the mouse?
Huh.
So the head portion, you can change the values and see. Like just scroll bar, you can move and see.
But I cannot able to do it, sir. Hello?
Hello, yeah. One second.
Where I have to click, sir?
On the head.
Head I am clicking, but it is not changing. It is a sliding, no, slider now, sir.
Yeah.
But I cannot able to slide it.
So I have given auto accept all requests. So some participants can try moving the screen, like moving the mouse. Yeah, Dr. J. Marudu Pandi.
Tell me, sir.
It is saying it is waiting for Dr. J. Marudu Pandi to control your screen. Can you please check any notification you have got? Yeah. It is possible. Yeah. Just try moving it. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes. Now it is working.
Yeah, you can just type moving it. You can press on it and drag also. So I hope all participants are able to get a feel of what controlling a robot through internet is. Is it fine, sir?
Fine. Okay. The code is written in Java.
Code is written in Java.
The platform only is different. Basically.
Yeah, platform is different. So anyone else who wants to control and see, there are 57 participants. Please type your name in the chat box so that I can see if you are interested in controlling the robot. I think it is possible through cell phone, Gajendra Singh. I'll try to give access to you. So, Ramachandra Rao, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, I'm giving mouse control to you. You just try moving the robot.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, it is saying waiting for you to control the screen.
Yes, sir. Able to.
Yeah, you can try moving it, moving the hand.
Yeah, left hand. I am trying to move the left. Head part.
Yeah.
And here, right hand. Yes, sir. Okay. Able to do it.
Okay. So I'll explain the code right now. Sir, please stop controlling it.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
I hope at least some participants were. I hope some two of the participants were able to see how it is being done. So with this, at the later part of the session, we can also have others who haven't tried it. We can have a session where you can try to move this robot. So this software is called as processing. Actually, I haven't shared this code with any one of you because this is particularly used to control this particular robot. So this processing serial is the file which is used to open the import processing serial is used to open the serial communication between the computer and the robot. cc.arduino, import cc.arduino, I hope everyone has idea about Arduino. So this Arduino header file is included, and then the p5 processing, that is control p5, is being used. Then processing.video is also imported because we have to check how to see the video on the screen. Next, capture. What we are going to capture is a variable named cam, and this cam will be used further to capture the videos. So next, what we have assigned is control P5, and variable control P5 has been assigned, and Arduino has been defined as Arduino. So next, head is initially set to 90. Whatever you saw, the head was at 90 degree. The motor can rotate from 0 to 180 degree, but the head is initially set to 90 degree. Then the left hand is set to 90 degree, and the right hand is set to 90 degree. So then the image which came at the bottom, that is Robo Pandit 2, actually was because this image was imported on the screen. Next, the size of the screen is being said. So what happens is the size of the screen is 1300x740, and then this screen which appeared when I ran the program, that is this screen, the size of this screen is 1030x740. So next, what happens is the cameras are being defined, and the length of the camera, that's camera dot length, is number of cameras in the connected to the system. If there are no cameras connected to the system, it will say that no cameras are connected available for capture. Otherwise, it will search for available cameras, and it will print the camera name based on the number of cameras which are connected to the computer. Next, what happens is the cam start. I can also. Increase the font size. I hope you can see it better. So next, the camera starts. Next, the camera starts, and what happens is it goes to the list and prints Arduino list. If it is available in the port, this is, I am using Linux platform. So the port name is Dave TTY ACM0. If you are using Windows, it would be COM0, COM1, COM2, COM3, something like that. So what happens is next, we are running this loop continuously. That is the slider which you saw, that is the head of the robo is added. That is the slider is added. And then initial range is set. Range is set from 0 to 180 degree because the servo motor can rotate 0 to 180 degree alone. And then it is label of the thing is called as head, and the size and the position on the screen is defined. So 20 pixels away from the top corner, that is what it means, and 5 pixels down. And similarly, left hand and the right hand are defined, and the image called as robo.jpeg, which is in the database, is loaded. So then what happens is void draw. It starts writing the analog signal to the microcontroller. That is, it is connected, the head is connected to 9th pin, left hand is connected to the 10th pin, and the right hand is connected to the 11th pin. So with a delay of 15 microseconds, it does the process again and again. If the camera available is true, then the camera is read and the image is displayed. So this is what is this code about. So if you have any doubts in this code and how this robo work, you can ask now. So can I proceed? Participants, please inform me like whether I can proceed or I need to explain this code again.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the hardware, if you have these hardware, it is very good. Like Arduino UNO, micro servo motors, male-to-male jumper wires, a normal LGB or LED, normal RGB LED, or a normal LED with each with single color, and 10K potentiometers. But we are not going to focus on this hardware in this session, because some of you can have, may have it and some of you may not have it. So yeah. What I'm planning to do is, I'm planning to give a virtual session, like you can virtually control the robot on your screen, the following robots. And then you can, whenever you get this hardware, you can order it online or you can buy it from some shop near your home. And then you can start working with it. So what we are going to... Hello. Hello. We are going to use Arduino to control the hardware. So Arduino can be downloaded from this website. The software, next software which we are going to use is processing. I hope everyone has downloaded it. And because we are using processing because it is an open source software and it is a flexible software sketchbook. It will be used to visualize our robots and it will act as a graphical user interface for the robots which we create. So processing is an open source software based on US and getting started with programming. So there are two things which we need to see. That is setup, void setup and void draw. So whatever you put it in void setup will get executed only once at the start of the program. And whatever you put it in void draw will get executed over and over again. So this is the basic difference between void setup and void draw in programming with processing. So next, a software called as Blender. We will be using the software tomorrow session to create robots virtually and so that we can see how the robots appear on the screen. That is, we can control those robots virtually and see. Okay, coming to the heart of the topic, that is parallel manipulators and serial manipulators, which we will be controlling in today's and tomorrow's session. So serial manipulator is something where the links are arranged in series, and a parallel manipulator is something where the links are arranged in here. Another motor will be here and another motor will be here. So this is called as a serial manipulator, but whereas a parallel manipulator, multiple legs are connected together to a moving platform so that the moving platform can do the intended work. So serial arm, inspiration is a person playing table tennis. So this is because while playing table tennis, we need not apply more force. So we can actually apply less force on the ball. So only one hand is being used. That is, a serial arm is being used. So, but if you are going to see a parallel robot or a parallel manipulator, the inspiration is something like this. In cricket, we'll see people holding the bat with two hands because they have to give more force on the ball so that it reaches the maximum length or distance. So in serial arm, the force, that much force is not required, but in cricket, that a large amount of force is required. So what I try to say is, in this right hand and left hand put together is manipulating an object of interest, that is a bat. So here, if you see, the end effector in a serial manipulator will be a, in case of table tennis, it is a table tennis bat. In case of cricket, it is a bat. The end effector would be, and we'll be actually moving the bat with two hands. So in a similar way, a serial manipulator has three, this is a three-axis robotic arm. So it has joint one, joint two, and joint three. And the joints can be seen over here. And that is similar to our arm. So next is a parallel manipulator, where which can be considered as our leg. And this has a 6 degree of freedom parallel manipulator. So this also can be controlled using computer-controlled robots by using computer. So coming to the hands-on session. So are you all participants with me? Can we move on to the hands-on session?
Yes, yes.
Okay. So I hope everyone has installed processing and you can open processing on your laptop. If you have any doubts, you can feel free to ask me or post in the chat. So have you all participants opened the screen? Please respond.
Yes. Tell me, sir.
Yeah, if you have opened the screen, we'll move on. I'm just saying, waiting for others to open the screen. So it can be opened only on a computer. It cannot be opened on a mobile phone. I'll wait for a minute more so that you can open the screen.
Your file name is sketch_2019-17BS.
Can you come again?
So your file name is sketch_2019-17B. Right?
Yeah. It can be anything for you.
Okay.
It can be different for you also. So that is not a problem. I hope you have downloaded the file which I had sent you. And please place it on the desktop and extract it. So okay. The link I have sent it again. In that page, there will be an option to download it. So you can see the download button option over here. Please extract on your desktop alone. So I hope you have the file folder called IoT Robotics on your desktop. This is the thing which you would have downloaded, IoT_robotics.zip. And this file folder should have come on your desktop. So are you all participants with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you please go back to processing this sketch and go to file, open desktop, IoT robotics, and try to open this robotic underscore arm folder and click on robotic underscore arm dot ptg.
Sir?
Yeah.
Can you tell me one more thing?
File. Open.
Okay.
So if you click on open, you will get something like this. I'm using a Linux system. Maybe based on your system's thing, you will get something. Please go navigate to desktop. Okay, sir. And click on IoT underscore robotics, the folder which you have downloaded. And then click on robotic arm. And then double click on robotic arm dot PDE. So if you go back to the, I'm just showing this. I hope everyone has opened the screen and this code is available on the screen. Does everyone have this code on the screen?
Sir, but for me,
yeah.
This control P5, there is a class called control P5.
Yeah.
In that, it is showing in error.
No. Please don't run it now.
Okay.
I'll tell you because we need to install some libraries. So what we have to do now is we have to go to sketch, import library, add library. I'll show you again. Sketch, import library, add library. So if you scroll down, there will be something called as control P5.
Yes.
So click on it and click install. I have already installed it, so it is not a problem. So if since you have downloaded it for the first time, you need to install this library. Control P5. Please click on install. So are all the participants with me?
Yes.
Install, sir.
Sometimes.
Okay. So what you have to do is first we'll run the program and see. So just click on run. So you'll get us some screen something like this. Have you got it?
Got it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you can just try to move the base.
Yes.
The base would move. The yellow color link. Then the green color link. You can rotate it. That is the shoulder. And finally, the arm. So is everyone able to rotate it and see?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in future, if you want to make some robots like this, I'll tell you how to write the code. That's just an overview. Like this is a three-axis robotic arm. But if you want to make a six-axis robotic arm or something like that, you can make it by extending these three sliders more. And you can actually connect this hardware. You can connect this thing to the hardware, and then you can also try moving it. I'll show you a video of it. So I hope you were able to see the video, and this is what I'm trying to say is, not only virtual robot can be made, you can also make your own hardware and then try to control it, the hardware, through this software. So that is what I'm trying to say. Okay. So has everyone got this output?
Yes, sir.
There are 87 participants. Please reply. At least
yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'll go on to the folder. I'll just show you what this program is about. If you open this thing, there will be a robotic arm on your system. There will be something called as data and robotic arm underscore PDE. So if you're going to open data, so this is, you'll see arm, base, body, shoulder cylinder, and a temp file. So what happens here is, this robotic arm is made up of a CAD. The CAD model consists of this arm. That is being given over here. That is in OBJ format. And what I'll do is
MTL file, sir.
MTL file is something which is generated by the software so that it can understand it on the model on its own.
What is MTL, sir? Expansion.
I'm not sure about that. I'll let you know. This is OBJ is object.
Object file that we know. It is something different.
So what I'll do is, I'm opening a software called as Blender, which probably tomorrow we'll see a hands-on session on it, because you need to install the Blender software. We'll see it tomorrow. But I'll show you like how I'll import the object. So this is what is called as wave font, that is .obj. So I'll go to my desktop, navigate to my robotic arm, data, and the body, or the shoulder cylinder. ShoulderCylinder.obj. So import object. So it has imported the object. So what we saw here is this arm, that is the green color arm. So it is with a magenta color base. So green color arm with a magenta color base. I'll now show you how the arm was created. That we'll see tomorrow, but I'll show you how to change the color of the arm. So you can click on this cylinder over here, and you can go to colors. And you can change the color to something blue. So this color is green, so you can try changing it to red. So what I'll do now is I'll save it again. I'll give export wave font desktop. So it has saved it again. I hope this color of the robo would have changed from green to red. Okay. We'll export it. Okay, fine. We'll see this a little later, but I'll explain you the code. This float rotation import control P5 is we are controlling, we are going to use this to control the sliders. Then float rotate X, rotate Y, rotate, translate X, translate Y is a scale factor, and the scale factor are used to define the rotation of the object. Then we are using float offset, that is, we are offsetting some objects. If we need to offset some objects, we'll be using float. Then P shape, body base, body, shoulder, arm, and shoulder cylinder and arm. So next we are opening a control P5 variable called control P5, and control P5 another variable called my controller. And what happens is we are initializing the base to 0, the shoulder to 0, and the arm to 0. So what we are doing is next is void setup. Whatever is inside this will run only once, as I had told earlier. And what we are doing is we are setting the screen size, that is in P3D, that is in three dimensional, we are going to see the objects in the screen. And next is the smooth rate. And smooth means a transition between each frame will be smooth, and the frame rate will be 30 FPS. My controller, we are defining a new controller, that is, this is a control P5, and we are adding the slider, controller.slider. And we are setting the position of it, that is for X rotation, Y rotation, and Z rotation. Then, as I had shown you earlier, inside this data, that we can see arm, base, body, and this is being defined over here. So So the body, we are loading the shape body.obj that I had shown you in Blender. The base object is loaded, shoulder cylinder, then the shoulder cylinder.obj is loaded, and the arm, then the arm.obj is loaded. And we are trying to control this base. So what we are trying to do is we are creating a slider called as base, and the set position is 10, 10 on the screen. Set size is for 200, 440, and the range is 0 to 360. Because now you can see it rotating 0 to 360. That is, it starts from a point and ends at that point. So if you want to use a servo motor, you can change it to 180, save it, and then run it. Now the arm will be rotated only to 180 degrees. So this is what is the use of the function called as range. So if you're using a servo motor, please make sure that it with it, if it has 180 degree, 0 to 180 degree and 180 to 0 degree servo motor, it rotates for that angle. Please make sure that it is range is set to 0 to 180. Then color value. The color value is set to 0, that is black. The color label is set to 0. The color active color, that is the what color we are seeing, that is the active color. Then the foreground color of the slider and the background color of the slider. So these are all set up. So these three, active color, foreground color, background color, are nothing but, if you're going to this and pressing on it, it shows an yellow color. This region of it is shown as like grayish yellow. So that is the active color. If you take it out, it will show in gray color. That is the foreground color. And the background color is nothing but the color which is at the back. That is RGB value we have to set it. In a similar way, we will create an slider for arm and shoulder. So coming to void draw, that is whatever is there inside this will get repeated again and again. So the background color is set to some color. That is, you can also use the tools color selector, and you can check what color it is. What we are using is RGB 183, 242, 124. So this is the color. So the background color is this. So if you want to set it to some color like this, you have to choose the color over here. If the background color needs to be in this color or something lighter than that. And you have to note down the values here, and we have to change it here. 169, 129, 122. Color will be changed to from green to light magenta or purple. If you run the program, you can see the color change. So are you all with me, or you want to try it? You can try it now. So can I proceed, or you want to try?
Sir, colors.
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Sir, what were the values which you have set?
You can set any value. Actually, you can see the color selector.
Okay.
And you can choose your own color over here.
Okay.
So, and you can try to put RGB values in the background color. For example, now I'm going to give dark yellow, which is of course very dark. So 255, 247, and 3. And the background color will be in yellow color. yeah, this is in yellow color. So next what happens is, I'll start explaining the program. So next what happens is the void base fixed function is created, and then we are choosing void draw link base. So this function is called. So what happens is it goes into this function and push matrix and pop matrix. So it is a set of values which are sent as matrix, and a translate is used to translate the object on the screen. And scale is something which we use to scale the model, and the base is the 3D object which we defined over here. So this is the base. So that is nothing but base.obj will be added to this. So you can now see the difference, because I am going to change the scale value. Before that, I'll show you on the screen what is the base. So this is the base, and if you are going to change the scale the value to 0.5, and then if you're going to see, it would have become bigger. So it has almost covered the robot. So we can say double it actually, 0.24. So the base is now big. So even if you make some model in Blender and save it as a .obj file, you sometimes need to scale it up or scale it down. So that is where the scale function comes into play. So next is the shape base is called. Next, what we are doing is we are rotating about y-axis the base. So this base is nothing but the value which we are giving in the slider. So the base slider value will be set over here. And it will be rotating. Next, what we are doing is the body. We are bringing the body into the program. That is shape. We are importing the body, and next in a similar way we are importing shape and the shoulder cylinder and then the arm. I hope you have gained some knowledge with respect to this part of the robot, of the code. So if you want me to repeat something, or if you want me to say something more about this, I can say.
Participants can unmute themselves and can ask the question. I've been given the permission. Thank you.
Okay, I do hope you have understood this. This next, what we'll see is the uncommented, the commented lines in the program. So if you are going to connect a hardware to the computer, and then you need to uncomment these lines. First line is import processing.serial, because you need to uncomment this, because the serial communication between the computer and the object, that is the microcontroller, will be started, and then import Arduino. See, ports can be defined if we uncomment this. Then you need to uncomment this line Arduino space Arduino. That is, the variable name is Arduino, and then this line Arduino is equal to new Arduino this comma the port name and the communication rate. This port name has to be put inside this code, and then the pin mode has to be initiated, and then later part of the program you need to say that the base, which is rotated, that is the slider value, has to be passed as a PWM signal, that is analog signal, to the 8th pin, 9th pin and 10th pin for base, shoulder and arm respectively. So if anyone is facing any difficulty in running the program, or if you are facing a difficulty in other parts of this program, like changing the color or something like that, you can ask me. I hope you have understood. If you have understood, or if you have any doubts, you can post it in the comments so that I'll get a feedback that how to proceed.
I request the participant to make use of chat box, or either you can unmute yourself and ask the resource person.
Participants, please be active in asking questions, because this is afternoon session. I'm sure that many of you might feel sleepy. Okay, one person, Fani Kumar, has said understood. Yes, understood. Feel free to ask questions. This is just an interaction session. So can we move to the next program, like the second part of today's session, that is on a song controlled robo?
So you can continue. Yeah.
So this is going to be the output of the program which we are going to see now. So the virtual robot is dancing, and the real robot will also dance. But in today's session, we'll be seeing the virtual robot dance alone. So you can close this program for now, and now you can go to processing and go to sketch, open desktop IoT_robotics, robot dance, song dance, and open the file robot underscore song underscore dance. So have you all opened it? Participants, are you all with me? Like on the screen? So, is there anyone who is facing this issue of like there is an error line under the sound? Processing dot sound.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So what you have to do is you have to go to import library, sketch import library, and then add library. Sketch import library and then add library. And down we need to install the sound library. So you click on this and click on install.
And you can provide that in chat box, sir, so that will be useful for other participants.
Yeah, I'll repeat it. Like, you have to go to Sketch, Import, Add Library. And if you scroll down, there will be something called as Sound. Sketch, import library, and then add library. If you scroll down, there will be something called as sound. Please install this library. So is it installed, participants? Participants, I'm waiting for your reply.
It's downloading.
Okay. So one issue which you might face with this program is that because if you are on a mobile phone and then using a computer to access the code, then it would be fine. Because your mic is connected to the app, Zoom app, the possibility of the program getting run is very less. Because the sound port, the speaker is being used by the Zoom app. That is how you are able to hear me. So what you can do is you can disconnect from the session and then run this program and see, so that the two robots will be dancing on the screen. So if you can do that, it would be fine. And please come back to the session. I'll give you a 5 minutes time. Time is now 5:09. We'll get back at 5:15. 3:09, and we'll get back at 3:15. please open this program. If I try running it, it will show error most probably. Actually, it is. So this would be the expected output. For me, it is coming. For you, if it is coming, that's not a problem. If it is not coming, it is because you are connected to the Zoom app. So this is the expected output. So five participants, are you able to get it?
Sir.
So a person has asked how much time to develop the code for robots. So for both the programs which I have shown, for first program it took nearly a week for me to develop the code because I did it for the first time. And now on, it might take, if you have understood the program, it will take hardly a few hours, like 2 or 3 hours to develop a code for the robot. Participants, are you able to get the output? Can this type of projects be given to UG students? Yeah, it can be given to UG students. I have been testing it with students in BTech colleges, and they find it very easy to work with it. And even in their final year project, they are able to make their own robots and control it using this software called Processing. Okay, can I proceed to explain the code? Okay, I'll explain this code. Here, what we're doing is we are importing the sound library, and then sound sample is being declared, and amplitude is being declared as RMS. So what we are doing is scale value is set to 5 because we'll be using the scale value in the future, and the P shape is base body, shoulder, shoulder cylinder, and arm. So float, what happens? Float smooth factor means that the wave which we get out of the song will be shortened by this factor. So next is we are declaring sum, and we are declaring public void setup, and whatever is inside this will be executed once. So the size of the screen is 600,400. So you can see the size of the screen here. So this is 600, and this is the height is 400, and the length is 600. And if you want to change the size here, you can change it to 1000 or based on your screen size actually. And you can click run. So now if you have able to see that now the screen has become a little bigger. we can change the screen size, and fill is the color which it has to be filled with, and the sample sound file, that is 3.mp3. So this 3.mp3 is actually in the robot_song_dance, whatever we downloaded. Inside that, inside data, the song is there, the mp3 format, the song named 3 is there. So you can also try changing the songs, but you make sure that you give a proper name to the song and put it over here. You might have some songs in your computer. You can also try it now if you wish. You can copy that song, put it over here, and then you have to change the file, this line, that is 3.mp3, to the file name. For example, if you are playing Janagana Mana, you can play janaganamanas.mp3, and that is how you change the file name over here. But don't forget to put the quotes, so you can put it here, and the sample will be played in loop, that is, it will be played continuously. Once it completes playing the song, it will come again and it will play. Then the RMS value, that is the amplitude for this, the RMS value is assigned, and then the sample is given. Then the body, face, shoulder cylinder and arm are declared. So whatever is there in the file, so this file, arm, base, body, shoulder cylinder, they will be declared, they are declared over here. And the object is being loaded, and the whatever object is there in the database is being named as base, shoulder cylinder and arm. Then void draw. So what we are doing in void draw is the background color, that is, which is going to be getting repeated. So that is, we are changing the color over here. This 255, 255, 255 means it is white in color. Then you have to put this code will be similar to the previous code which we saw. So what happens here is we'll push the matrix and translate it to some distance on the screen. If it is 0,0, for example, you may not be able to see the robo. Because the 0,0 is this corner of the screen. It will take a little time to load. So if you can see, the base of it is over here. So if it is 300,350, you can see the robo at the center of the screen. Like, it has translated 300 pixels this side and 300 pixels this side on the screen. So then we call the function called as draw base fixed, and void draw base fixed is being seen over here. So then what happens is we give the RMS value, and we write a function for that. You can later look into that, how it is written, and we are getting the sum, and the sum is then given to the scaled RMS, and it is rounded off. That is the value A, we get the value A, which is rounded off value. So that is an integer, and we are going to push the matrix and load the base. So that is going to be stable. So next, what we are seeing is the A value, that is based on the amplitude of the song and the frequency, the sound wave generated by the song. We are converting. We are asking it to rotate about y-axis by A by 160 degrees. The value of the A is scaled down, and it is converted to degrees. In the similar way, shoulder cylinder value is being done, and for the arm also it is being done. So this is for the second robo. You saw one robo in the first session, but if you're going to see this session, we'll be showing two robotic arms. That is because one more time it is being given, and it is being translated. So one of the participants had asked, if we uncomment the lines, what will happen, whether we can connect it to the hardware and test. Yes, you can connect it to the hardware and test. So that is done by import serial, as we saw before, processing.serial, cc.arduino. So these two lines you need to uncomment so that you can connect it to the hardware. And then you need to uncomment this line called as Arduino, space Arduino, that is declaring Arduino. And then we need to see which port the Arduino is connected to. And for that, you need to assign the Arduino to this port. And then we'll be seeing setting the pin numbers, which will be seen over here. So this analog, the 9, 10, and 11. So these three pins, it will be writing the values. That is, the ninth pin will write the value A divided by 160. That is, the pulse width modulation will get this value. The robot will get the value and it will start moving accordingly. So that is how it moved in this video. I'll play the video again. So if you have any doubts regarding this, if you have got the output, I'm happy. If you have got any, if you're not getting the output, you can tell me what error it is, or try to find it on the internet, like what error it is. And that is how we learn programming. And if you have any doubts in this particular program or the previous program, you can ask me. So if you run the output, it will take a little time. So it is playing the background. So if you have any doubts, or if you like to control the robotic, like the humanoid robot which I had made, maybe we can try it out now. So if you're interested, I can connect the humanoid robot. I'll bring it to the screen so that you can connect it through the internet and you can try to operate the robot which is in my home. So not only this robot, but you can also connect any robot to the processing software, and you can try to make it work. For example, this is a cable driven soft robot which is able to walk on the floor with bent legs. That is, legs are very soft and the servo motors are being used to control the cables which are connected to the leg. So these kind of robots can move forward, backward, and so forth. by writing program on the processing software and connecting it to this. So this is a standalone model of the robo. So the battery, everything is on the board and it is walking forward. So again, the question which would be in many of your minds right now would is like, can I control any robot that I build using a computer and ask my friend who is sitting outside my house, like anywhere in a place, the far off place, to control it using the computer? Yes, it is very much possible. And it is very much possible with open source softwares. You need not pay a single rupee for that. You can easily download it and you can install it on your computer and you can work with it. So next is a book on computer controlled robots, which I have written. So you can buy this book on Amazon so that it is like titled Build Your Own Computer Controlled Robots from Scratch. This teaches like how to control the hardware also and how to build your own hardware. So if you have any questions or if you like to control the robo, I can very much devote the rest of the time for that. I'll try to open my Pandit robo. And bring it on the screen. So if anyone wants to see it, control it and see through a remote control it and see through remote, I can offer you. So I have given allow auto accept all requests. So you will be able to send the request and you can start controlling the screen. So there are a lot of people like who have been silent throughout the session. At least you can try it now. You can tell your name so that I can, if you can see your name on the screen, I can give access to you. You can use your mouse from your home and try to control this robo, which is in my home. You can uncomment, like unmute yourself and you can ask for control. So any participant who is willing to operate and see it. So should I start calling out names? Like, so please come voluntarily. Participants, I just expect you to be active. You just ask me control. I have given auto accept for all requests. So you can start controlling my screen. Like you can move the cursor, my mouse, and you can try to see what is on the screen. And you can, the robo will also move accordingly. So some person has raised their hand. You can go ahead and ask your question. Unmute yourself and ask your question. Participants, are you with me?
Any participants, if you want to control the robot, please raise your hand. Manjula madam, Bali Kumar sir, sir, three members are ready sir. Raghavendran, Bali Kumar sir, Manjula madam are ready. I think they are.
Okay.
Madam, you can unmute yourself and.
So you can unmute yourself and tell a few words so that I can. Your name appears on the top, and it will be easy for me to give the control
please
to you.
Please raise your hand.
You can unmute.
You can unmute.
Option forward. Already. Sir, forward. Pradeep Kumar B, sir.
Pradeep Kumar sir, come sir.
Yes sir. Pradeep Kumar B.
Yes.
My name is.
Yeah, but I have given auto accept all things. So yeah, I think you will be able to control the screen. Please try the remote option on your laptop.
Where the control is there? Control.
In your system, please see where the remote control option is there and try to get send me a request and then we'll start. I'll give you an acceptance so that you can control the robo and see.
Pradeep sir?
Any robot designing free or open source software is there?
Yeah, Blender is there. FreeCAD is there. CAD model. So to make CAD models, you're asking, right? For CAD models, software which is very good to open and use. So I have given auto accept for all requests. So if I'm not able to see you for no reason, I don't know why, not able to see the names of every participant in the remote control. So Ravi Kumar R, if you are there, I can try giving you the access. Ravi Kumar R. So I hope everyone has the option to ask remote control access from the from me. So I've asked the organizer to try controlling the robot. AICTE-HTTP. Are you able to control my screen? Yeah. So you can go to the head and you can try moving the head. No, like this corner. The corner on the top. The head portion, which is over here. Now you can try moving it. No, not on the robo head, but on the slider, which is on the top left corner. Yeah.
Sir, EI path and blue share is there, sir, to design the robot software.
Can you come again, sir?
UI path.
Yeah, UI path is there. Okay. I haven't worked on it, but I think you need to pay for that.
Okay. Blue share is there, sir.
Huh?
Blueprint, sir. Other software.
This software name is processing, what I'm using right now. But you can use for CAD modeling, you can use FreeCAD, FreeCAD, CAD.
Okay, thank you.
So I think they're able to control the screen. Yeah, okay, fine. I'll go to the next part of it. Like, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. We have 20 more minutes to control. I think Prakash VS had asked whether he wants to control the robo, if I'm not wrong. If you can see the name, your name on the screen, I can try to give access to you. So the name of the software is FreeCAD. So the session is up to the participants, like whatever questions you have, you can ask. If you have any doubts, I can clarify.
So now this is a QA session. Please, any clarifications or any questions related to today's session, you can unmute yourself and ask.
So I think we can end the session because no one has questions. If you have any questions, you can write to me at vsrajashekar@gmail.com. Please mind the spelling vsrajashekar@gmail.com.
Sir, in a Kindle version, this book is all pages are open or not, sir?
Yeah, if you buy it, every page will be, you can access it with the programs.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any questions, please ask. So, shall we conclude, sir? Not say it, sir?
Yeah, we can conclude.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for spending a valuable time with us, sir.
Yeah.
Actually,
yeah.
That this hands-on session is more, I think, very informative. I hope all the participants also enjoyed more, I think.
Okay.
Thank you very much for your participation in the festivity, sir. Actually, we have tomorrow we have two sessions, sir.
Okay.
So Solomon Raju from CERI Bilani also will join us by tomorrow.
Okay.
That is Central Government Institution, sir. Solomon Raju, CERI Bilani.
Okay.
Tomorrow he will join, and his topic is IoT related design issues. He will deliver one lecture along with our Raju Sagar, sir. So thank you very much, sir, for your valuable time with us.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay. Now I have served that feedback links also, so the participants can take the feedback link from the chat. So another 2 to 3 minutes, you can fill the form. Thank you very much.
Okay, sir, I think I can log out.
Yeah.